All right. So for Monday, or so excuse me, for Friday, December 4th, not Monday yet, we're going to look at, I'm just going to review again what I reviewed in class. For some people, they were unclear. And at first there, I'm a little understanding of it. I got cut off in first hour. But so let me explain what you're doing and the jigsaw and where the materials are at for the jigsaw. I'll explain it one more time in case you missed it. And then we will, and then we'll go from there. And then we'll explain the Bossuet reading again as well. Okay, I'm gonna hide my fat head so that I can more easily concentrate on the slide here. All right, so let's start with slide 6 and 7, absolutism, authority, activity, a Bossuet reading. So we went through this thing already. The power of God can be felt in a moment of, and from one end of the world to the other. So great about August, about royal authority. You've seen a great nation exalted under one, knighted under one man. So keep in mind, this is the Pope, or excuse me, the Bishop of the Catholic Church, preaching in the court of Louis, 17th century theologian in the 1600s, preaching in the court of Louis. You're writing a response to Bossuet's position in number 7, keeping in mind that is what you think about the author's position and what the role of the monarch should be. Keep in mind a couple of different things here as you're thinking about this. Thinking about a couple different things. Number one, we view things through the eyes of democracy. And you have to realize that at the time, Louis coming in and being a king, or any of the absolute kings, may have been a welcome change from the days of feudalism and running in the lords. So there could be a difference there, and you have to understand that this is good for them. So that's something to consider as well, that this might actually be better, might actually provide a more stable government for them as you're going along. You must consider that. You must consider that. When you're taking in the idea what the author's position should be, when you think about Bossuet's position and what do you think the role of the monarch should be. Again, you could look at it from your modern lens and say, well, the absolute authority, you know, remember we did the positive and negative aspects, absolute authority isn't necessary, but consider those traits as well. And again, what effects would Bossuet's words have on the people? And why? Well, what effects would his words have on the people? Consider that his words would probably be treated very seriously because you must understand, because he's a bishop and he would be respected. But remember, he's filling the vacuum of the Pope, left by the Pope in the Protestant-Catholic conflict. All right, second. That's due in class. And then second, that would be more considered like the homework. Second is the Friday activity. Now with the Friday activity, here's where you're looking. Number one, I'm gonna go back to first hour. Number one, you have to consider that you have two attachments here. Name picker, okay, and then you have the jigsaw numbers. So again, remember that what you're looking at is Philip, let's say Philip II, bottom of slide 8, okay? And you let's say you have that one. So let's say if you're in first hour, Tithe, Cecilia, Sophia, okay, you have number one. And you're going to go to, it says to on slide 8, the bottom, this is the bottom that we're referring to, page 589. So on page 589, what text we're looking at with page 589 is this text right here, okay? Talking about the Spain's, Philip II's reign in Spain, 589. And this the questions can be answered here. In addition, if you have Louis or if you have Peter, there are sections here on Louis and Peter that can probably be answered there as well as on the links. So let's go back to this and say, okay, you have Louis, graphic organizer or Peter's graphic organizer. I tell you exactly where they are and exactly what slide they're on. Okay, so then you go over here and you have, you know, 2, 3, 4, Peter, Ty, Tyler, Jack. And again, for each hour they're here, I'm using first hour as example. And the primary reason I'm using first hour as examples because I got caught off them a little bit. Okay, so back to the graphic organizers in the notebook. So this would be Louis. And you can, again, use that text section that I pointed out, or you can use links to Louis here, the Sun King, because he's so glorious. A sentence or two on the significance of these, l'état, c'est moi, I am the state, the Palace of Versailles, how he controlled the nobility, it at Versailles, expanding France, stabilizing the economy. And so some people have the first three. Some people have the first three over here, 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 here. Okay. And then some people have, let's just let me erase more easily like my hover cam does, but apparently it does not. And some people have this one, and these, okay. Stabilizing the economy and how the French people suffered. Okay. And again, so you know if you have these by looking over on this slide, which can be found in the classroom attachment. Okay. And then you have, and then those of you that have Peter, some of you have the significance of westernization, how he reformed the Orthodox Church and the westernization. You remember, he westernized because he went to Europe and saw how they were making progress, and he felt like he needed to be making progress as well. Now, some people weren't happy with the westernization, the creation of the Savoy Martyr Port at St. Petersburg, the Boyers, the military, and general reforms in society. So again, if you have those on the attachment, they're right here. And slide 16, the last three, or slide 15, the last three. And how will you know that? Again, back to the name picker, corresponding what number you have. It corresponds to what number you have here. And I'll make these bold. What number you have here, and I'll make them a different color. What number you have corresponds to what slides you're doing. Okay, what number you have here corresponds to what slides you're doing. I don't know how to make it any more clear than that. The idea, yes, it's due Monday in class. The idea is that while we will not continue, we will go through it next week, maybe not all in one day, but because of the way class is structured in this situation, I'm going to have you do it as the Friday activity, and then we'll continue it in the report outs next week, so we're prepared to answer questions about that. So, yep, this would technically have been the homework. This is technically the Friday lesson activity that you're supposed to be doing on Friday. Friday is, again, not a day off. And if you're still working on your short answer questions, you need to get those done ASAP, as well as the test on Synergy and any exploration notebook as well. So that's something to consider, to think about as we're going along. Okay, hopefully that explanation is there. And we will see you on Monday with these things complete.